This evening, we are at fourth summit of airport modernization conducted at Bangalore, India, co-sponsored by Tricon. We are fortunate to have the general manager of GUSEL, that is Gujarat State Aviation Infrastructure Development Company Limited. And I found your presentation very interesting, sir, this morning, and couldn't imagine that a state could do so well in a very specialized field. Sir, I'll be very happy if you can speak to us or the Aviation Defense Universe, which is our organization, about two aspects mainly. One is about the initiatives which are very different from other, number one, and number two, about water aerodromes. Mr. Gupta.
Thank you, sir, for inviting me and for complimenting my presentation on behalf of my company. First of all, I would like to convey my regards, our company's regards. Our Captain Chauhan sir is the CEO, and they are coordinating so much things. They are initiatives, number of matters also in the aviation fields. So let me introduce one by one activities what we are initiating at the different states. So firstly, we have got the three operational airships. One is at the Mehsana, second is at Amreli, and third one is at Mandvi, that is the Kutch. And that Mandvi airstrip has the specialized location that is adjoining to the sea beach area, and we are developing it as a tourist hub. It will have the multimodal facilities for the tourist, recreation, entertainment, and all these things can be provided with better connectivity, better stay facilities, and all these things. So we are redeveloping our Mandvi airstrips. Furthermore, we are developing four more airstrips out of the 11 planned. So these four airstrips under development, physical development at the location are Ankleshwar in the Bharuch districts, then Morbi, second, and the third is the Rajpipla and Palitana region. So these all airstrips will be coming in a very near future. The Ankleshwar airstrip is the largest one, 2200 meters length is there, and other small airstrips are coming at these locations. Over and above this, Rajkot Greenfield area is co-developed by the Airport Authority and Gujarat Government and GUSEL is facilitating them with the acquirement of the land and these various permissions. And Tolera International Airport is a separate company. It is co-promoted by the Airport Authority and the Government of Gujarat. So these are the development steps we have taken it. Other initiatives we are developing six heliports. Heliports, presently conventional heliports or helicopter helipads does not have any other facilities except the helipads. But we are building small terminals, so they can be charter helicopters or the charter services can be taken care of them by the passengers. Small terminal building will be there, an appropriate approach, so that to six airport heliports we are developing. It is in Ahmedabad, Somnath, Gwir, so Saputara. So these are the different locations we are developing, and they are in the advanced stage. Now we are coming one more initiatives, because aviation assets is increasing day by day in the Gujarat also. We need the qualified security is the major concern area for any aviation operation. So that's why Government of Gujarat and the GUSEL has planned to create their own aviation battalion, and they will function as per the Bureau of Civil Aviation's guidelines, their mandates, and their training protocols. So we are creating this one, and in the near future it also will be come up within the Gujarat. So this will take care of the civil aviation security of this all.
Thank you, sir. I think very good initiatives. Now I think second part we will cover the water airports.
To continue with the previous versions, and before coming to the water aerodrome, I would like to highlight two, three more things government of Gujarat and government of India has initiated this aircraft leasing business at the GIFT City, Gujarat. So this will provide the much financial facilities to all the airline operators and leaseholders, so they can provide the leasing facilities. Government has given the various relaxations, so this will be the huge saving from the foreign currency outgo. So this is one of the game changer will be in the financing industry. The second is, we are developing the cargo complex at the multiple locations. We are looking after the various potentialities. So various the underutilized airports or airstrips, cargo facilities can be created and they can be operated on the PPP modes. So this we are developing it. And now let me come to this water aerodrome. So water aerodrome is the a vision of the our Honorable Prime Minister of India, and they have taken very care initiatives and monitoring also simultaneously. Their guidance also provided, and this we could provide and construct from commissioning, stretch, planning, commissioning, construction, permissions and operation. We all completed within the 45 days merely, from the 10th September to the 26th October 2020.
That is amazing.
Thank you, sir. And it was our privilege and proud honor also that it was both this water aerodrome at the Sabarmati Riverfront and the Statue of Unity Kevadia were inaugurated by the Honorable Prime Minister. And further, they also themselves traveled in the seaplane from the Statue of Unity to the Sabarmati Riverfront. And it was very energetic and enthusiastic provided to our whole Gujarat and the particularly the Gujarat team. So these are the various problematic issues were there, but all were managed, like site excavation there, some other issues were there, security concerns also there at Kevadia, but we all managed there, and appropriate assistance, guidance were also provided by the airport authority, Sardar Sarvanath Nigam, and other co-sponsored authorities and agencies also. So now we have India's only one seaplane services has been come up in Gujarat, and it will be set example for the other development. And thereafter, Ministry of Surface Transport in coordination with the Ministry of Civil Aviation, GOI, has also planned to develop more water aerodromes. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Mr. Gupta. It was very educative, I must say. And I never thought that a state could do so well. And credit goes to your MD and your chairman and your chief minister. And of course, the initiative of the Prime Minister. And thank you for sparing time for ADU.
Yes, and thank you very much, sir. I also would like to add one more thing. Our Secretary, Civil Aviation and Government of Gujarat has also always provided the initiatives and guidance. So only with their guidance and support, we can provide and get the facilitation, all this from their side, and that's why we could achieve such targets and progress.
Yes, it is always there, sir. Unless the seniors support, you cannot complete your mission and vision. Thank you very much, sir, to be with us.
Thank you.
Wish you all the best for future.
Also wish you a healthy life. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.